Hello guys, welcome back. Let's see one of the C language question which was asked in GATE 2009. Consider the program below. Here they have given few lines of code. Please pause the video and go through it. And they are asking for what is the output of the given code. They are asking. Let's see that. You know, every program will start executing from main method. Immediately they have declared one integer variable x by initializing a value 15. You know, for every variable there is a some address. Let us take its address as 100. Immediately they are printing printf percentage d comma function of 5 comma address of x, means they are calling one function by passing 5 comma address of x. What is address of x? 100, means it is calling the actual method function of. So here you will get 5 comma 100. As I am sending the second parameter as address, the second parameter should be a pointer. So that is why they declared here second parameter as pointer. So they have declared one pointer called f underscore p, which contains the value 100. As it is having a 100 as a address, means it is pointed to like this, means it is waiting at outside of this particular location. Similarly, n value is, then immediately they have declared one local variable t and one integer local variable f. Then they are checking if n less than or equal to 5. Is 5 less than or equal to 1? No, condition fails. Then it is going to execute this statement. For our understandability, here I am defining statement number 1, statement number 2, statement number 3, statement number 4. Okay. As this condition is fail, it is going to execute the 1, 2, 3, 4 statement, right? In the first statement, here they have written one function. This is a, means here two functions having same name. So we can say that it is a kind of recursion. So whenever you are executing the first statement, means it is a kind of assignment statement, right? Means whatever the value that is written by this function statement, that should be assigned to t. So first it should be executed by this func of n minus 1 comma pointer variable. So it is once again calling this function. So here it is a concept of recursion. So I would like to explain this with the help of a stack. Let us take a stack. So initially what will happen? We call with func of 5 comma 100. When we are calling func of 5 comma 100, it is created variables like this. Then immediately it is going to execute this first statement. Why? Because n value is not less than or equal to 1, so it is going to execute the first statement. So when it is going to execute the first statement, it is going to call func of n minus 1. What is n value? 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. 4 comma 100. After successful execution of this statement, which statement is going to execute once again? First statement, the remaining part. First statement, remaining part. Means once this statement is completed, it is going to execute 1, 2, 3, 4 statements. Okay. Now fun of 4, 100 is calling. Means now my n value will be 4. F underscore p is 100 only. Now is n less than or equal to 1? No. So once again it is going to execute first statement. So fun of n minus 1, that is 3, 100. So once again it is going to execute first statement only. You had understood that. Means it is calling 3 comma 100. When it is calling 3 comma 100, n value is 3, f underscore p is 100 only. 3 less than or equal to 1, condition fail. So then it is going to execute first statement. It is going to execute fun of n minus 1, that is 2 comma 100, first statement. Now it is calling fun of 2 comma 100, 2 less than or equal to 1, condition fail. So it is going to execute the first statement once again, that is fun of 1 comma 100. After successful execution of this statement, which statement you need to execute? First statement. Now it is calling fun of 1 comma 100. When fun of 1 comma 100, my n value will be 1. Now it is going to check, is 1 less than or equal to 1? Yes, condition is true. When condition is true, it is going to execute the body of the statement. Now it is going to execute this block. star fp means it will fp is what 100 star means you know we'll move to inside this location when you got star we'll move to inside the location so star fp means this value is replaced with the value 1 fp is 100 I am waiting outside whenever I applying star fp I am going to inside for that it is going to assign the value 1 so my x value will be now 1 then immediately it is going to return 1 return 1 to what function 1 function so this function will return value 1 value 1 to what first statement right understood here value 1 to first statement is what t equal to means my t variable value will be 1 means here the garbage value is actually there this value is replaced with the value 1 then immediately its second statement third statement fourth statement will execute so second statement is f equal to I'm writing here f equal to t plus star underscore fp star f underscore p equal to t it is going to return f so this is second statement third statement and fourth statement so second statement is what f equal to t plus t value is what 1 plus 1 plus star underscore fp fp is 100 star underscore fp is 1 1 plus 1 2 that 2 will be assigned to here f value 2 now star fp means inside equal to t t value is what 1 now 1 is replaced with 1 then it is going to return f return f means what two values return two value return to which function the previous calling function means the to this calling function it is written means this function is written in the value 2 written in the value 2 here it is written in the value 2 means that value is copied to where the variable t so now t value will be 2 t value will be 2 then the second statement is executed second statement t plus means 2 plus star fp 1 that is 2 plus 1 is 3 that 3 will be updated to f then immediately star fp equal to t star fp is what this one equal to t means 2 then it's going to return f is 3 so this particular statement is written into fun of 3 as 3 value means that value will be copied to t variable so t value will be 3 now then immediately the second statement is executing second statement is what t plus star fp t value is 3 star fp is 2 so 3 plus 2 is 5 that 5 is copied to f then star fp equal to t means like this then it is going to return f return f means 5 will be returned means this function is returning 5 value to here means as I am returning means it is simply equal to t equal to 5 means my t value will be now 5 then immediately second statement f equal to t plus t value is 5 5 plus star fp is 3 the 5 plus 3 is 8 8 will be updated to f then star fp equal to t means 5 will be copied here then it is going to return f what is f 8 means this function is returning 8 value to this function 8 value to this function means we required this value only right so means this entire thing will get the value 8 that value is going to return so print percentage d comma fun of 5 comma address 100 means you will get the value 8 so 8 is our answer it is simple one but you need to know the knowledge of stack concept here I hope you understood clearly. Thank you.